person likes banjo boys, and it's a guy. Wow, I'm sorry. What's your name? I'd like to talk about pickup lines, right? When did they start? Do they really work? How did they catch on? Because I'd like to think, like, back in the day in very old England, there were these guys who were fighting their game, right? They were going up to women and were like, oh, voluptuous bosom and nice birthing hips you have, my lady. Right? But what was happening here? They were calling the Mexicans, man. They were forcing us to speak English. What's the first thing you do when you learn a new language? Abuse. Perfect. First abuse, second hit on women. Right? Unfortunately, to date, all I've seen is, oh, she's so hot, but I'd like to add my chili to her. It's even worse, man. Just after, oh, we go together like samosa and chole. And my personal favorite, a baby, with the desi, indesirable. No, man, see, this is a problem now, because most Indian guys I know have insane talk of him, which results in stuff like stalking. Ladies, you have to look at it from the guy's point of view. There's some poor guy, probably has a social anxiety disorder or something, or his mom told him he's beautiful on the inside. So, he thinks he can go up to any female, but then he never really talks to him, just stands in the distance. If I was a girl, I'd be damn creeped out, because there's some guy following me, never talking to me, just silently in the distance. You know, I think I'm losing it. I need to check into an asylum. Or I could just stop with the acid. But then the teddy tubbies and the unicorn friends would be very sad. See, the problem is guys don't know what women want and they won't tell us. Like, we can't understand each other, right? I would find it easier to understand the conversation between Batman, Bane and Darth Vader. Ask a girl, what do you look for in a guy? Well, he has to be romantic and go with me for long walks and hold my hand. Also, I want him to listen when I talk. And thirdly, I want him to love me for my brain. Like, you don't want a guy, you want to date a zombie, clearly. Oh man, but I can relate with women on a little better level than most of the guys, because when I was a kid, my parents put me into this intense ninja training sort of thing, right? I don't know if your parents ever did this, but they'd be like, oh, get that from there, put that over there. And if you didn't figure out this code, you'd get punished, right? Because I'd walk home, I'd get shouting, and they'd be like, I need you to do the work. Was I in the room when you told me to do the work? What's wrong with you? Don't ask, man. Of course, young man, you're in the room, I want me to talk to myself. That's it, I'll be out here. Man, what just happened? Right? At least I had it a little better than my sister. Because she was insanely bad at this, right? Something as simple as eating. Once I'm done with dinner, just put the things by. And the next day I found my TV remote in the fridge. She always had this one standard answer, right? It's like, Betty, why are the khakis in the fish tank? You told me to put that there. Okay. Betty, why are the plates in the dishwasher? I mean in the washing machine. You told me to put that there. Okay, why is Nana sitting in the car? You told me to put that there. And who helped you dig up her body? And that's why I pray that I'm adopted. Because every day I wake up, look at that thing. Ladies and gentlemen, that was my father's best form at some point of time. Alright, that's my